Hawkins, who is the creator of the 12 for 12 art show. But just to give you a little information about myself, I am the creator of Etc Blog Mag, everything natural hair, fashion, and style. So I'm very honored to have you here with me, Shelton. So we're going to get right into it. So the 12 for 12 art show,
yes,
can you give us kind of like an overview of what that is?
It just started with me. I love the sneakers and, you know, like, the way I approach sneakers and everything like that. It's crazy, like, how it's so hard to get sneakers nowadays. Like, you know, you gotta go to the mall, you gotta write your name on a list and all this other stuff, or you gotta call somebody. So, like, basically it started with me wanting a pair of shoes that I didn't get. So when I didn't get the shoes, like, my natural thing was, like, I can just make my own shoes. So it started with me making one shoe, and I seen how dope that sneaker was once I came back, so I was like, you know, just went from one shoe to two shoes, and then it just kept going. Each shoe and each paint kind of have a theme, so each one is like inspired. So like for instance, like for February, of course I use Black History Month. So when I did Black History Month, everything's inspired by Black History Month, whether it's the colors, whether it's the name of the shoe.
We go back to 87, second grade, and I think I just dated myself.
I know.
But like we've been friends, best friends for a long time. I think we even fight on the playground over a girl or something like that. But he wanted to fight me, but it didn't work out.
So I saw that Shelton posted this is going to be the first and last art show. How do you feel about that? Do you think that he should continue doing this? Especially because so many people missed out on this show.
The funny thing about art is you can't force it. If this is going to be a one and done, you know what I mean? I got to respect that. But at the same token, I feel like he has something fresh and something I haven't seen before.
I was really, really proud that my brother Devon came in and performed. His performance was crazy. The energy was there. Like, you know, then for him just to do a CD of all unreleased records just for the show, I just thought it was just really dope. And it kind of went along with the whole theme and everything like that. So. And then the live band brought a whole different element. And it was like our first time collaborating with each other since kind of like first training days. So that was like really, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Well, us to do something kind of, you know, along those lines and still be dealing with fashion and music. That stuff was just really dope.
Yeah, I was impressed by the artwork. Like, hats off to you. You know what I mean? You know how we do. But like, I just felt like you kept telling me, like, wait till you see it. And I'm like, yeah, okay. You know, like sometimes, like I believe in you, like 100%, but I was, like when I actually saw it, I was like, yo, this is everything. Like I want like all the pieces in my house somewhere. I think it's good that we always talk about changing the culture and capturing the culture. And instead of complaining about it's nothing to do or we not seeing creative stuff, like us creating that, like I feel like we keeping that trailblazing tradition going on.
You don't have to be in New York and you don't have to be in Atlanta, like you don't have to be in a major city. If you do, people are gonna find you and they gonna respect what you're doing. Well, us in this area, you know what I'm saying, like to do something like that, take a risk and then like to see the reward. So it's gonna be really dope.
And then to come together for a common cause, and this was all for the community. So I think it's a good thing, and I think nothing but good things will keep coming from this.